You have a RAD 7 and you have completed a test. So now you want to download the data onto your computer in order to analyze it with free Dirge Capture software. This tutorial is going to guide you through a 5-step process in order to view radon data on your personal computer. We will go through equipment, install, connect, download, and analysis. When you're done, you will be able to graph the data, save an image of it, print or export it, and more. Here is the equipment that you need to connect to Capture. This is the RAD 7 with at least one completed test contained in its memory. To learn how to run a test, you can watch the video tutorial, Getting Started, Running a One-Day Test with the RAD 7. This is the RAD 7's power cable. You also need a null modem cable that goes into the serial port of the RAD 7, and then into the KeySpan USB serial adapter that connects to the USB B cable that goes into your computer, which can run on any of the following operating systems: Windows XP, Vista 7 or 8, or Mac OS X. Before using Capture for the first time, you need to install Capture software and the KeySpan device driver onto your computer. You only need to complete this install step once for the life of the computer. To complete installation, you need to have either the Dirge USB drive that was included with your RAD 7 shipment, or have internet access. First, let's install the device driver so that the computer recognizes the RAD 7 when it's plugged into its USB port. To start, plug in the USB drive into the USB port of your computer, or visit triplight.com/sku/USA19HS. On this page, under the Support tab, find the download link for your operating system. To install for Windows 7 or 8, click here. In the browser pop-up window, click OK to save the file. Access the folder called Driver for USA19HS, which contains the application file. Double-click to run the installation. Go through the installation setup windows by clicking Next, accept the terms of use by clicking Yes, then click Next. A prompt for registration appears. Click Cancel, and then click Exit Registration. Click Finish. You have successfully installed the device driver for your KeySpan serial adapter. The second part of the install process is putting the Capture application on your computer. You can install Capture from the Dirge USB drive or visit dirge.com/capture. Find and click the download link for the latest version of Capture for your operating system. In the browser pop-up window, click the Save File button. When downloading is complete, find the file called captureinstaller.exe and click to open it. As the Capture installer recommends, shut down the other programs you are running. Then click Next. Select version all languages or English only as you prefer, and click Next. Click Next in the directory window. Since the directory doesn't exist, you create it. It holds all Capture program files. Click Start to begin the installation. When Capture is successfully installed, a shortcut to the program appears on the desktop. If the Launch Capture checkbox is selected and you click Exit, the program will automatically launch. Once you have Capture software and the KeySpan device driver installed on your computer, you can connect it to the RAD 7. First, take the power cable and connect the RAD 7 to a power source. Next, take the null modem cable and plug it into the serial port of the RAD 7. take the other end and plug it into the KeySpan serial adapter. Take the adapter and plug it into the USB B cable. Take the USB end of that cable and plug it into the USB port of your computer. Now turn on the RAD 7. Once the RAD 7 is connected to your computer, you can download its data through Capture.
If it isn't already open, open Capture on your computer by double-clicking the shortcut on the desktop. The program should complete an automatic scan for devices and connect to your RAD 7. To start the scan manually, you can click the button Scan for RAD 7s on the bottom right of the screen. Once connected, Capture prepares to download the data. Choose where you want to save the data on your computer by clicking Select Download Location and entering the desired name here. You can change the file name or save it according to the default timestamp. Click Save. Choose to download either all the test data on the RAD 7, the latest test, or a specific run number. Then click Begin Automatic Download. See the data upload in the RAD 7 data box. When the upload is complete, the graph window and the radon source prompt window will appear. In the radon source window, select the type of test that you ran in the RAD 7. For any test done in air, leave the selection as radon in air. Then click Apply Parameters. After you download the test data to your computer, Capture displays it in the graph window here. As the program loads the data into the graph, it automatically checks to see if it needs to be corrected for humidity levels or for B2A window spill, and a dialog box will prompt you to make any necessary changes. You can change these settings manually at any time by checking the boxes here in the Configuration side panel. Above the correction boxes are menus which lets you change the concentration units, which modifies the y-axis scale here, and temperature units, so you can select Fahrenheit or Celsius based on your preference. On the graph, you can see that the x-axis represents time. See the timestamp values here, while the y-axis shows the radon concentration. So the graph shows a line of the change of radon concentration over time. These two blue lines, or selection bars, allow you to analyze a specific range of time. You can manipulate the range by dragging the lines horizontally. Hold Shift while dragging to move both selection bars as a unit. The Selected Area panel here shows calculated averages for the data points between the selection bars. See how the average radon concentration, air temperature, and relative humidity change as you drag the selection bars. To view a graph region in more detail, double-click the area between the selection bars. The view will zoom. It can be navigated using the horizontal scroll bar at the bottom here. Double-click between the selection bars again to zoom out. Statistical values are displayed for all of the data in the entire data range panel here, and for a single point in the point nearest to cursor panel. These values change depending on where you place the mouse cursor. Those are the basic methods for viewing radon data. You can also configure the graph using the Appearance panel and other panels located to the left of the graph. To read more details on the controls available in all panels, please see the Capture manual, which is available by clicking Help, Capture Help.
You completed an analysis of your RAD 7 data using Durage's Capture software. The data is now stored on your computer's hard drive, so you can access it at any time. Durage's software also enables you to complete additional analysis, including exporting the data in different formats. For example, an official radon inspection report, or a format that can be imported into Microsoft Excel, and more. To learn more about Capture's capabilities, you can watch Durage's video tutorial Using Capture 2 Advanced Analysis, or consult the Capture User Manual.